This is LING 270, Language, Technology, and Society. We will continue our examination of Module 1, looking at writing as a language technology. The first important point to be made is that writing is a form of technology. It is one so common that today you may not think of it as such. But it is indeed the case that writing is a language technology. To make that point, we are going to look at a case study from the 1840s in Fiji, recounted by Thomas Williams. The following is an excerpt from his writing. As I had come to work one morning without my carpenter's square, I took up a chip and with a piece of charcoal wrote upon it a request that my wife should send me that article. The chip was given to a man to deliver, but he was scornful of the errand and asked, "What must I say?" "You have nothing to say," I replied. "The chip will say all I wish." With a look of astonishment and contempt, he held up the piece of wood and said, "How can this speak? Has this a mouth?" On arriving at the house, he gave the chip to Mrs. Williams, who read it, threw it away, and went to the tool chest. On receiving the tool from her, he said, "Stay, daughter, how do you know that this is what Mr. William wants?" In this story, the messenger was amazed that a message could be sent in such a way across a distance without the use of speaking, and he asked for an explanation of this new technology. The well-known science fiction author, Arthur C. Clarke, once stated that any sufficiently advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. Perhaps then, an appropriate corollary to that statement is that any sufficiently old technology is often unrecognized as technology. This is certainly the case today with writing. Today, we are used to writing. Writing is common, and we don't think of it as a writing technology, a language technology, or any technology. But it is indeed the case that writing is a technology, a tool use that allows us to convey messages in the form of language across time and space.